Listen, you right here, you were giving me big energy the whole time. You were flailing your little arms in the air. How would you like some premium Wi-Fi to start off your cruise? You were shook to silence. This is for you so you can make all your friends super jealous, post all your pictures, and potentially, whenever you win one of these shore excursions, you can make everybody at home think you're like the king of aqua water sport. Go flying around and enjoy an authentic lunch right over there. Or you guys could even check out our private key with snorkeling, rather maybe the water sports. You just want to go snorkeling. Do I have any snorkelers out there? A few snorkelers. The rest of us just use it as a bigger straw for our drink, right? Amen. That's what I'm doing. But nevertheless, this one, okay, if you're not into the water sports but still want to have a little bit of adventure and not get, again, nickeled and dimed to try and get everything added to your package, this is the one to check out there with Maya Key. Now, where are my adrenaline junkies at? This is my favorite tour, hands down, that I do, and I'm going to go to Hoggy Bay. It's always a really good team bonding experience. We went out there, and I thought it was going to be like a super casual day, hopping on, like riding the quad through the field. No. You hop on these massive ATVs. You got to throw your whole leg over it, right? And you got to get on, like, whoa. And they give you like a do-rag, and then a helmet, and then like a mask guard, and then a dust guard, and then you're like, this is going to be intense. And it's been raining, which means that there's mud everywhere. So then you crank that bad boy up to 100, you go flying around, mud's going everywhere, and you take this ATV all the way up to this beautiful overlook that you get off, and there's a big picturesque moment where you can see all of Mahogany Bay. It is incredible. A great picture for you guys to really catch the memory and take it with you when you go. Then you hop back on, you go all the way down, and you drive on up to that beach, and sand goes everywhere. You're like, and then you get off, and then you get to have your beach excursion. And you get off, and you're like, all right, I'm gonna have a Victoria's Secret moment. I'm gonna walk into this beach with my little ATV. And then you try to be sexy, but you just walk like this. Because your legs are still shaking from holding on for dear life on the ATV. But it does give you both ends of the spectrum, that high energy, super fun moment, mud everywhere, and then you get to relax and rejuvenate at the beach afterwards. So definitely check that one out if you guys are looking for something, maybe a combo tour. You're only gonna book one tour and you wanna have both aspects. This is the one to get in on. But the last one, yes! See, Gabby, I told them that. See, Gabby knows, they love this. Oh, I thought they were cheering because they liked catamarans. You was dancing. It's free. That's why y'all like it, huh? Well, let me tell you guys, the Jolly Roger catamaran is a really, really great experience. You hop on right there in port. You sail out. You do a bit of snorkeling. And afterward, the rum punch starts flowing. And the good times start going. So who wants to go on that Jolly Roger catamaran? Is there a dog in it? Oh, I was like, there's a speaker. All right. It's an orange ticket. We all have orange tickets. Yes, I know that's the joke. Ticket number 3. Oh, that wasn't good. 3? 9. 2. 3. 7. 4. Is that you, my love? You gotta make some more noise than that. You have won the first excursion on Fun Aboard Fun Ashore. Give it up for this young lady. Shy's gonna come down. He's got legs like a gazelle to go and see Tulum. But this one you do. Item for sure. For those that have been there, you know all about it. But for those that don't, it is a historical site that is absolutely all over the internet that you guys can go and learn everything about and then post pictures and make all your friends jealous. And someone's doing it for free. And it's ticket number 392 219. Right over here, you guys, congratulations. Enjoy the ancient city of Tulum. It's gonna take care of you. You get up nice and early in the morning, head out there, and have a full day of fun. And speaking of a full day of fun, another place you guys can go and check out is Isla Passion. Y'all just say, Isla Passion is gonna make you feel just that. It is a private island owned by Carnival, and only Carnival guests are able to get access to this. So that means that you're not gonna be crowded with other people trying to peddle you bracelets, trying to braid your hair even though you're bald. They're not gonna bug you with that one. This is a chance, you guys, to really sit back and just relax and rejuvenate. And it's inspired by nature. Who doesn't love that? So if you guys want to check that out, there is two different options of getting there. You can take the nice casual power catamaran, or you can take the twister boat, you know, get your real riled up before having a nice relaxing day and bringing your blood pressure and the cholesterol down. So rolling right on through, we've got our X Great Bark. If you do not want to relax all day long and instead want to have a jam-packed day full of fun, then you're going to want to go see Scarret, right? See, I got my lady for it. She's checking me. All right, Scarret is over there. It's, again, on the mainland. And imagine if Six Flags and Hurricane Harbor and the coolest zoo you've ever been to came together, had a baby, and plopped it down there in Mexico. That is this fantastic adventure park. You have a chance to get really into everything, especially those that are traveling with maybe big families and everyone wants to do something different. And it's gonna cost you an arm and a leg to try and book everybody on all these different excursions, and you still wanted to stay together. This is where y'all want to go. It's got a nice secluded beach area, but it's also got adventure rapids and waterfalls, and it's got a lazy river that's not so lazy, takes you up under, through, and around caves, and then you've got chances to go and see wild animals that are roaming the grounds, beautiful birds, crazy cats, and even some dolphins as well. It really is the all-encompassing day for those that are out here with big families or just want to do a little bit something different this cruise. Check out Scarret Park there in Cozumel. Now, the dolphins swim in unlimited food and drink. Yes. Colombia, it's Mike. we are looking for some very brave and courageous families out there to get up here on stage and fill these four sets of seats. Does anyone want to play What Sage Got to Do with It? Well, I think we're ready, so we're going to get started and play, but we're going to play a little game first.
Absolutely.
Fantastic. Do you understand the rules?
I think so.
Okay, perfect. Have you ever played the game before? You've never played before. Well, have you ever used a microphone? Get closer. Have you ever talked to a mic?
I think so.
You think so. Well, today may be the day. All right, and over here. Now, who is this one?
This is Preston.
Is Preston related to you?
Preston is my son.
Oh, is he your only kid?
I have another child.
You have another child. Are you able to talk about them?
I am.
You are? Okay, good. I'm glad. And over here, who is this young man?
This is my son.
This is your son. Oh, and you love him so much, don't you? You do. You would do anything to get him on stage. Well, you guys are both really good at this game, so. Parents, check, check. It goes to the kids now. So kids, step on up. I know, listen, if I can't put the pressure on the parents, I gotta put the pressure on the kids. All right, so now it comes to you again. You can't say yes and you can't say no. Do you understand? And you gotta give me a real answer, okay? Okay, perfect. Do you understand? Excellent. Who's your Definitely is not. Yes, it's okay. And is your other sibling here?
Negative.
All right. Negative, Ghost Rider. And over here, is your siblings here?
Sure.
Where are they?
Right there.
Right there? Is that your little brother?
Sure.
Yeah. This is going to be a long game show. This isn't even a fun ride. This is the deciding factor. Apparently, these guys are really, really good. You're in the same family? That's right. How do you know this person?
Sorry, my cousin.
That's your cousin. Who's the better cousin, you or him? Is you why?
Cool.
You're cool. Is he cool?
Very much.
Very much. You are now known as the blue team. Y'all make the noise for the purple team. What's Age Got to Do with It? Again, to all of our contestants that wanted to get in, you can still play right there from your seats.
All right,
four fantastic contestants. Each of our junior cruisers has received a whiteboard. For this first game, we're going to play called What Would You Say? This is a fun one for the audience to play along with as well. So kids, I'm going to ask you a question. You're just going to write down what you think the answer is, okay? Write it real big, but don't let your parent look over your shoulder and see it, okay? We're going to keep the secrets from mom. It's only the one you're allowed to keep. Never keep secrets from your mom. Drayvon, get it together. Parents, now you guys are not going to look. You're not gonna cheat. I know you're trying to do this for your children, but don't cheat, because cheaters never prosper. Lion King taught me that. Y'all gonna catch up, don't worry. You're gonna write down those answers, and then we're gonna find out if you guys are gonna have matching answers. If your answer matches, you'll get a point up on the board, and the teams with the most points are gonna go on to our next round. So here we go, let's get the first question in. Sophia is taking this very seriously. Thank you, young lady. All right, first question is this. Kids, think about this. Who is your favorite singer? Kids, write down who your favorite singer is. Parents, you're thinking about who your child's favorite singer is, okay? What is her favorite song to jam to? Who sings it?
Oh. Hello? Wow? Hello? It's okay, I'm really loud. Hello? We don't really know what's happening, but the good news is, this is show business. Okay, don't look. You're gonna be disappointed. All right. Those people in the back, can you hear me?
Yeah!
Great, because this is the last words I'm gonna say.
Because I'm not gonna have a voice by the end of this. Oh, perfect, thank goodness. All right, Bianca, your sweet little daughter, Sophia, I need to know, does she have like a favorite artist?
I think she likes JoJo Siwa.
Girl, JoJo Siwa, I love that one. Rainbows and pigtails and cool light up shoes. So do you think that's her favorite artist?
Yeah. That's gonna be a tough one. She likes all types of music.
You raised your eyes, but you gotta choose one. She's written down one answer. Who do you think it is? JoJo Siwa. Okay, that's a good one. You like JoJo Siwa. But let's show the audience what you wrote. You said it was who, Sophia?
Frozen.
Frozen. It's Elsa. That's a good answer. JoJo Siwa, she auditioned. She didn't get the part. But nonetheless, good answer, Sophia. All right. Oh, that's a good one. That's one of my favorite ones. Two more. Come on, high five. High five. Two love. All right. Don't be leaning over there trying to look at the answer. Cheater, cheater, pumpkin eater. What is your son's favorite artist? His favorite singer?
I'm gonna say Travis Scott.
Travis Scott? What kind of trap house you running, child? What did you say?
Nick Jonas.
Thank you. A very age-appropriate guess. All right, Grandpa. Let's see if you know, because I don't think Cassie knows. Cassie, you come up with that's a good one. Who is Cassie? She's got something down now. Yeah, she does. What is Cassie's favorite singer?
Yeah, I'm going to say it's Taylor Swift.
T-Swizzle, my girl, Taylor Swift. Cassie, you can't write it down now. Show the people what you said. Show the people what you said. That's a good answer. I'm just gonna let you know, you're gonna have to make some decisions today, otherwise no points are going on the board. But the good news is, no one's got anything yet. Let's see if Mama knows her little bear. What?
I looked in my family to see if they knew, but.
But don't trust them either, because I don't think that anyone's gonna get this one. This is gonna be a kind of a wash of around. What artist do you think is your son's favorite?
I'm gonna go with Tupac.
Tupac! Progressive parenting over here. Tupac? No, instead it was who?
Tyler, the Creator.
Tyler, the Creator. Didn't even know he was an artist, honestly. Thought he was just like a guy on Twitter. Anyways, moving right along. Excellent job. Good news is we can erase those answers because it's a complete wash. What is your favorite thing to do before bed? Kids, what do you think your parent or your grandparents' favorite thing to do right before bed is? Y'all better stop. Y'all better stop right now. All right, cover, don't let her see, don't let her see. What do you think Grandpa's favorite thing to do right before bed is? Think it in your brain, don't say it out loud with your mouth. All right? The most favoritest thing to do right before you go to bed. Don't say it out loud, Sophia. Hey, back at you. All right, what do you think Mom's favorite thing to do right before she goes to bed is?
Eat.
Like, what does she eat?
Soup.
Soup? Like sweet soup? Like ice cream?
No.
No, she likes tomato soup right before she goes to bed.
Yes.
Excellent. So she said eat. Have a little snacky snack. And what did you say, Mom?
Watch TV.
Not quite. You were going to say soup. You was going to say soup. But you were like, no, not today. No sofa for me. All right. Over here, what did you say, Levi? What's your dad's favorite thing to do right before he goes to bed?
Eat dinner.
Eat dinner. Yeah, you guys would be eating and going to sleep. I don't know how y'all's functioning doing that, but what did you say, Dad?
Play on the phone.
Play on the phone. Play on the phone. Okay, not to stress. No points just yet. Over here, sweetness, what do you think Grandpa's favorite thing to do is right before he goes to bed? Play on his phone. And Grandma, what did you say?
Watch TV.
Watch TV while he plays on his phone. Not quite, not quite. Over here, man, we are having, these are tough questions, I know. What do you think your mom's favorite thing to do is just before she goes to bed?
I said read a book.
Read a book, very good. What did you say, Mom?
Read a book.
It's a point for the red team. All right, what sound does a dog make? I don't think you're nine because your sarcasm level is high. What did you say, Grandpa?
No.
No! A point for the orange team. And over here, what do you think your mom's favorite animal is?
A dog.
A dog. Any particular one?
I have no clue.
Yeah, just a dog in general. Mom, what did you say?
A cheetah.
A cheetah! All right, well then you guys, let's take a little look at the leaderboard right now. It is 2 for the blue, 2 for the red, and then 1 for the purple and orange, which means we're gonna do one more question. One tiebreaker question here. Now, it's not gonna reflect up on the board, but if you guys do get a match, then you have a chance to go on. But our blue team and our red team, you guys are going on to our next round, so this is our last question on the clock. Ready, set, go. If you don't know it, you can always say pass.
Pass.
Okay. Don't look.
They dress in a lot of different clothing and it looks really funny.
Next word.
Yeah, pass, sorry. Okay, you have a pair of these and I forgot mine. Remember what did I forget to pack? But you said I could borrow yours. Say it.
Sunglasses.
Point for the blue team.
We put this on our fries and burger, but we can't give it to the dog. Guess?
No. Ketchup. That's a good guess, though. That's a really good guess.
Go. Play this with a team.
Oh, what's up? Orange team.
Do you like this?
That's weird.
These fly. Stick this. Ass.
Next word.
This one you stick in a snowman for his nose.
Carrot. Point for the orange team.
This.
Next word.
We bought one of these at Bucky's for Noah one time.
No.
No. The other thing. You got on.
Play for the orange team.
Pass.
Next word.
You. These have.
Body. Bathtub, washcloth. Hot sky, round fire.
Fire going.
Point for the red team.
Safety.
You can use more than one word to describe it. Answer. Put your lid on. There you go. Everybody's locked in. Grandpa. That's a grandpa answer right there. All right, you got it locked in? Perfect. Okay, so we're going to go to the kids first, our hot seat. So again, if these answers are revealed up here on the stage in the panelists, it's going to count as a point. Miss Cassie, it took you a little while, but you came up with a real good answer because you said, good. Show the audience. She said, thank you for being good. That's a Very good answer, Miss Cassie. And what did you say over here, Tyler the Creator?
Thank you for being a friend.
Can you sing the song? Do you know the song?
Nope.
Do you know what show it's famous from? Do you know any of the Golden Girls?
No.
A travesty. Mom, what are you doing? All right, show the audience. He said a friend, all right? So if a friend or good shows up on the panel, it's gonna give them a point. Don't erase it and keep it up, okay? So over here, I was gonna get emotional for you, but it's not you. All right, show the audience what he said. I said, thank you for being, and you said?
Mom.
You said, the best mom. Look, show them like this. Look, that's how you read it. She said, the best mom. That's a good answer, Sophia. It doesn't come to her. You get a point physically and mentally, okay? What did you say? You said, thank you for being? A friend. That's a point for the red team. Over here, what did you say?
For being honest.
Thank you for being honest. Wow. Teach them young. What did you say? Thank you for being?
Kind.
Thank you for being kind. Both good answers, but no points. Over here, Grandpa said, thank you for being?
Quiet.
Yes. And thank you for being?
Thoughtful.
Good answers. All right, we are all tied up 5-5. Lots of points. All right, Cassie, turn your board around, and what did you say?
To get to the other side.
To get to the other side. And what did you say?
To get to the other side.
To get to the other side. Imagine. That means anytime to get the other side appears, they are each going to be getting a point, which means it's still going to be a tie. We're coming up here, though, because we want to find out. What did you say? You said?
The chicken car. It's because to go get to the other side.
To the other side! A point for the red and a point for the orange. All right, what did you say?
To get to the other side.
To get to the other side. Another point for both teams, orange and red. What did you say?
He was going to see his friend.
Yeah, his friend, which was the batter and the grease and the fryer. Those are my best friends. And what did you say?
To get to the other side.
A point for the orange and the red. All right, Dawn, what'd you say?
To get to the other side.
To get to the other side. Another 2 point right there. And over here, what did you say?
To get to the other side.
Nicely done. All right. It is 10. Okay. Sophia, we're going to come to you in a minute. All right, Cassie, you had this one down dead quick. You knew exactly what this is. Having two beds is fine, but 6 would be? It would be hard. That's a lot of poop to scoop. That sure is a lot. I don't know, the kids still do that these days? Tell me, what did you say?
Too many.
It would be too many. Now those are different. Hard is different than too many, okay? So they're two different answers. So anytime the hard shows on the board, that means our team over here, our orange team, is getting the point. As it says too many, means the red team is getting the point. So let's take it over here and see what Sophia had to say. Sophia, oh, that's a good answer. Having 6 pets would be what?
Good.
It would be good. Very good. But someone else's bank account, what did you say?
Crazy.
It'll be crazy. Not quite a match. What did you say?
Chaotic.
Chaotic. Good vocabulary word. Over here, what did you say?
A handful.
A handful. Again, not the same as too many or hard. Over here, what did you say, Grandpa Don?
Too many.
Too many, which means it's a point for the red team. Which comes down here. Mom, you said it would be what?
Crazy,
which is not an identical match, but you guys both did such a great job. Miss Cassie, I'm gonna have you go back over there and sit next to Grandpa. And you know what, Mama Bear, I'm gonna have you come on over here, because taking a look at the boards right now, there is a clear winner, 11-10. They have been battling it out all afternoon long. You guys stand up, look at each other, give each other a big high five, as you have just won what they've got to do with it. The winner is the red team. Congratulations, you guys, but not only are they walking away as the winners of these brand new 24 karat gold ships on a stick, you're also walking away with limited edition Carnival Inaugural Jubilee hats. Very exciting. But it wouldn't be a game with the kids if we didn't give everyone a prize. So everyone is going to be walking away with their very own 24 karat gold ship on a stick.
In marriage. We are going to be looking for one more couple tonight, as we do have two couples up here on stage. This third couple that I'm looking for is the most passionate couple out in the audience. Do I have any passionate couples in the audience? Victor, I lied. I am going to need house lights. I'm so sorry. My goodness. Sir, where is your hand at? Get your hand out of there. Oh my God, Pappy. Put it down. Put him down. Don't let her fall off this stage. Don't you let, stop it. I said passion, I did not say make a baby. Release her, Kraken. My gosh, all right, audience, I need you guys to tell me.
That's why I'm here.